Hey everyone, Jason here, digital marketing consultant, and in this landing page software review comparison for 2020, we're going to answer the question, what is the best landing page software for? Fill in the blank for whatever your situation is. So timestamp table of contents in the description, along with some deeper dive reviews, looking at the pros and cons of each one of these individually, as well as comparing them side by side. So here we're going to go through all the solutions you have, and then I'll link up in the description to several playlists and videos that take a deeper dive on these individually. So before we dive into our three sections here, we're going to look at landing page builders, then we're going to look at landing page builders for WordPress, we're going to look at landing page builders that are also just full-blown marketing suites and funnel builders, and then finally we will wrap up with my personal recommendations for each one. So I've heard you loud and clear, I'll actually give my personal recommendations of what we use at the end of the video. So as we dive in here, there are two very important things. Number one, whatever software you choose, it needs to have split testing. For some reason, not all landing page softwares have split testing, as you're about to see. You need A/B split testing. Saying to use Google Optimize or Google Analytics experiments doesn't count, because you can do that with a non-landing page builder too. So, and those solutions are free. And if you don't know what those are, that's okay, because you don't want to have to mess with those. And then number two, you want to make sure that if you already have an email autoresponder, the landing page software that you're looking at actually integrates. And what I mean by this is you need to go to the landing page software site that you're looking at, you're going to scroll all the way down and you're going to look for support links or their knowledge base, and then search your email software provider or email autoresponder provider and actually look at their support to see how it actually integrates. It's so ridiculous how many of these landing page softwares say, hey, we integrate with this one, and then you go and look and it has to be done through Zapier or automate.io or something dumb. So make sure that it does actually have a native integration. And I'm just including this here at the beginning since I don't know what your email autoresponder is. So you're definitely going to need to make sure that it works with whatever solution you wind up choosing. So we'll kick things off with just the straight landing page builders. That's all they do. Standalone software as a service. They build landing pages and that's what they do. We're going to be looking at lead pages, InstaPage, and Unbounce. Now, the first two I've actually used and I just have some secondhand experience with Unbounce. So first we're going to go through arguably the best one on this list. So go ahead and hit that like button if you like that you got your answer within the first 3 minutes of the video. And that is going to be lead pages. Hands down, of all of the page builders, when it comes to just landing pages, lead pages wins. It wins for two main reasons. Number one is the price. You're not going to be paying hundreds of dollars a month for the software. And number two, it has the largest template selection out of all of these solutions. Now, their lowest priced package actually does not include A/B testing, which just makes it absolutely useless. So you need to go with their middle tier package or higher. And so that's what we're going to compare here. You're going to have an incredibly large template library. They also have two different types of templates. So if you're one of those people who just wants to dive in, choose a template, change out the copy, and then get going, then Lead Pages has you covered, because they do have some templates where all you have to do is change out the text and it's actually designed to just be ready to go. That's something I really liked about Lead Pages, there we go. But if you are one of those people who wants to customize everything, then Lead Pages also has that ability. They also do integrate with almost every other software or marketing software suite or autoresponder that you could think of. So they do have a pretty robust integrations set as well. They also allow you to do checkout. So you're not going to be doing anything fancy with sales funnels or upsells or downsells or cross sells or little order bumps. But if you need to collect credit card information to sell your service or product, then Lead Pages also has you covered there. Now, the next on our list is InstaPage. And InstaPage is complete overkill for 90% of business owners and entrepreneurs. InstaPage is something that I actually used to use when I worked at a marketing agency, and I really liked the page building experience. I found it just as fluid and easy as Lead Pages, although my business partner, in contrast, does not like InstaPage at all. So the page building experience. So it definitely seems to be either you really like the page building experience or, oh my gosh, this is not intuitive and it's just annoying how many times you have to click. So what is great about InstaPage is the ability to create dynamic tests. So if you're spending $10,000 to $20,000 a month in Google ads for search, then you're actually going to be able to change your landing page headlines and certain copy elements based upon the exact ad that was clicked. That's really cool. That's really awesome. They have some really sweet analytics around that. They also have heat maps. I mean, if you're a data and analytics nerd, like, this is for you. Of course, the only problem is, if you're not spending 10 or 20 grand a month on advertising, then you probably don't need all that stuff. And paying $150 a month just doesn't make a whole lot of sense for most people compared to all that extra stuff that you get that you're not actually going to use compared to lead pages. And finally, we have Unbounce, which starts at $160 a month and then goes up from there. And that I really only recommend if you are looking to start your own marketing agency. You're definitely going to need at least three clients paying you anywhere from $150 to $200 a month in management fees in order for the math to work out for you to actually buy their enterprise plan or their mid-tier plan. And that does it for the landing page builder. So it might seem a little, this might list probably seems a little short and anticlimactic, but lead pages is just continuing. Even in 2019, it was the top, and in 2020, it's still the top. Now, when it comes to doing more than just collecting that name and email and then shipping that information off to your autoresponder, there are some full-blown marketing solutions like ClickFunnels, Kartra, Kajabi, GetResponse, and Converti. So we're going to talk about all but the last one simply because I haven't had personal experience with it and we haven't had any clients that have used it. And so go ahead and take a look at this chart. This is all of the math that we could talk about. So let's just get the pricing out of the way before we even start talking about features. The cost column shows the actual monthly cost of the software, not with getting locked into an annual subscription. So year one is assuming that you pay month to month. Year two is assuming that you actually like the software, so you go ahead and prepay a full year. I definitely don't recommend paying a full year for a software that you haven't figured out whether or not you like it, because these softwares change and you might halfway through the year realize, oh, actually my business grew a lot, so maybe I need to move, or it's not as great as you thought. So it's very important that you don't just dive in and try and save that 20 or 30% and get locked in to a particular service when you're not quite sure if you love it yet. So then the total column shows your total costs over that 2-year period, and the limits are actually what's very important. So you can look at the abilities. They pretty much all do the same thing, but something that's very important to note is the limits on Kartra and Kajabi. You'll notice that with Kartra, their starter package, you can only have 2,500 people on your list. Now, I don't know about you, but if you go 2 years and you're paying for the software and you only have 2,500 people, you probably have a software that's way overkill. So you're most likely going to be stuck with the silver package, and that gives you up to 1,250 leads. And so this is pretty much just your list size. It's the same way GetResponse is measuring how many people are on your email list, although you can tell that GetResponse has a much more reasonable pricing structure. So I'll allow you to pause the screen if you want to look deeper on all of these. I'm just going to point out the two that make the most sense economically. Number one is ClickFunnels, and number two is GetResponse. Now, the only reason ClickFunnels wins in this category is because GetResponse does not have a very good shopping cart sequence, it doesn't have a shopping cart sequence. So there you go. So what's nice with GetResponse and ClickFunnels is you can have landing pages, you can send emails, you can kind of do webinars with ClickFunnels. It's more just a video on a page. It's not really a webinar. And then you can have your sales pages, and you can also have a checkout. Now, then ClickFunnels goes a step further and allows you to do upsells and will integrate with your membership software or allow you to create membership sites with their basic software. Although I don't really recommend doing that because it's not very robust. Although GetResponse can be integrated with membership site softwares using Zapier, but again, you're adding another extra layer, so it's not really an integration. So if you're looking for something that's one and literally one and done, then ClickFunnels does win in this category. If you're willing to add a shopping cart software, or you are looking for something that's going to work on top of the membership sites that you already have, or you just don't care about membership sites, then GetResponse is going to be the best value here. So it just depends on what you're looking for. The main drawback of ClickFunnels is just it's not very fast. When it comes to building your pages, it can feel clunky at times. And then when it comes to your actual page speed, which is why we actually don't recommend it to any of our clients, because when you're driving paid traffic, Landing page speed is so important. Some crazy statistic like every second that it takes your landing page to load, you lose 10% of your conversion rate or something crazy like that. I don't know the exact statistic, but it is a huge, huge difference. And so for that simple reason, we almost never recommend using ClickFunnels. Although if you really want something that's one and done, it's hard to beat everything that you get. So you kind of get the quantity instead of the quality with ClickFunnels. So before we move on to our final winners across everything here, let's go ahead and talk about WordPress. There are two main options when it comes to plugins that are specifically designed for making landing pages. Yes, there are a ton of page builder plugins like Beaver Builder and Elementor. Although when it comes to actual landing pages, I think Thrive Themes and OptimizePress still offer the best value and easiest setup. So Thrive Architect is going to cost you $97 a year. You can do up to 5 sites. And OptimizePress is going to charge $99 a year and you can do 1 site. Now, the main difference between these two actually comes down to the first thing I talked about at the very beginning of this software review and comparison for 2020, and that is A/B split testing. It's crazy. We are on OptimizePress 3.0, and there's still no native split testing inside of OptimizePress. And so for that simple reason, and also Thrive Themes has a lot more templates, but for that simple reason, if you're looking for a landing page builder specifically for WordPress, you don't want to pay a software as a service, then Thrive Architect is going to be the winner here. Now, it's important to note that Thrive also has a bunch of other products and OptimizePress has a bunch of other pricing with a bunch of other products. I don't recommend those anymore. So if you're looking to just build landing pages, then definitely go ahead, check out Thrive Architect for WordPress. But if you're looking to try and build an entire funnel, I actually don't recommend doing that on WordPress. Then you might want to consider one of the software as a service solutions like Lead Pages or Get Response, because it's definitely going to reduce your headache. And just setting up membership sites on WordPress is an absolute nightmare at times. And so neither one of these solutions offers a very robust membership solution, even though they both have those in their feature sets. So that does it for all of the different types. We went through just landing page builders, going through those sales funnel builders, and of course, some WordPress solutions. So now it's time to crown all of the winners or review all the winners and then reveal what we actually use right now. So if you just want to build landing pages, that's all you need. I need a page builder. I want to optimize conversions. I want people on my list. If that's all you need, Lead Pages offers the best value of everything that we've talked about so far. Even though their price point is close to what you would see with GetResponse and ClickFunnels, at the end of the day, Lead Pages, when it comes down to just the landing pages, they win. That's all they do, and it really does show in their software, their template library, their page building experience, and of course, their page speed. Now, if you're looking for a solution that's going to allow you to get everything done, you don't just want to collect emails, you want to collect emails, you want to send emails, you want to have sales pages, maybe a webinar, and you want to collect payments, and you want a membership site, then we're actually going to cheat a little bit here, and I would recommend going with GetResponse and then Teachable. And so that would actually cover you with both everything that you'd need to do online, and you'd only have to use 2 pieces of software. You definitely need to add Zapier in there to connect the two automatically, but it is a relatively easy integration. And I think it's well worth it when you compare what you can get with Teachable, especially you can start with a free plan. So technically you're still ahead than compared to ClickFunnels, where yes, you do get everything, but it's not worth it. You're sacrificing way too much in quality and tech headaches. So I definitely recommend, that would be my recommendation for a full-fledged funnel if you're looking on a budget. Now, of course, if you're trying to do a WordPress-based landing page or funnel, then Thrive Themes is definitely going to be your best friend there. And you're going to have to check out other solutions if you want to host your membership site on WordPress, although I don't recommend it. Wishlist Member or Member Mouse is probably going to be the place you want to go. Now, what do we personally use? Well, we use a small combination of what I recommended with GetResponse and Teachable. Although instead of GetResponse, we actually use a software software solution called MailerLite. And the reason it didn't make it onto this list is MailerLite pales in comparison to the landing page capabilities and functions compared to all these other solutions. So if these solutions were actual landing page builders, what MailerLite could do is more like a really watered down version of a landing page builder. So maybe by 2021, they'll make this list, but in terms of their basic functionalities, it just doesn't cut it as being called an actual landing page builder yet. But it works for us, it keeps things simple. So we use MailerLite for our landing pages. We also use it for sending our emails. And then we use something called ThriveCart, which I haven't talked about, but I'll link up in the description. It is a shopping cart software that allows you to do upsells and downsells, and it's a one-time fee of $500. So it's pretty reasonably priced, and you don't have to pay month to month. And then we do use Teachable for our courses. And so that's what we personally use, and those are all of my recommendations based upon just landing page, doing a complete sales funnel, and then trying to do something on WordPress. So if you have any questions about any one of these solutions, or you have your own opinion or experience with one of them, please drop it in the comment section below, because your questions and experience is going to help other entrepreneurs, creators, and freelancers figure out which solution is for them, because there's so many variables to consider. And I sincerely hope this rapid fire review and comparison has been helpful in figuring out which direction to go with. So go ahead and hit that like button, subscribe for more deep dive software reviews just like this one, along with tutorials on how to actually put all of this together. So until the next, keep building the business you love.